Time switch. In this one, then, we are going to be looking at a Horstman VMK 5 SRS. What we've got there then fixed to the wall is just a time switch. This one, it does not do rate changer trigger. It's just a time switch. It switches on a load and then switches off again at predetermined times. Let's zoom in on it then and take a look at the characteristics for this one. Okay then, right, what we've got there on the specification plate is a voltage rating of 200 to 250 volts for the synchro motor. And the all important part is that the synchro motor needs 50 hertz alternation frequency in order to run at the correct speed. Resistive load is 80 amps maximum capacity. This one is a Horstman VMK5 SRS as detailed there on the specification plate. Because of the scratches and scuffs on this the front case there, it's a bit difficult to see all of the details on this. I will open up the case in a moment or two. Right, there's the clock face. Once again, as like other VMK time switches, you've got the square winding shank in the middle of the clock face there for winding up the spring reserve. This one does have a multitude of togs on it. They're all bunched up there, sort of all in one place. There's a variety of off and on togs there. Regrettably, one of the on togs is missing its little pin. And as you can see at the end of the on tog, there's just a little threaded hole apparently there. And it seems to be missing that little pin in the end there, which is a little unfortunate. I don't know if I'll be able to ever repair that. If I can't, then, well, it's most unfortunate. Also, similarly, one of the other on togs, someone has tried to cut it off. There it is. But it's still long enough, amazingly, to actually reach the operating lever in order to turn the time switch on. So there we go. I will open up the case in a moment, but just there we can see that there is a star wheel inside this one. And what that can be for is you can set that up to emit either on operations or off operations. These can be fitted to VMK2, the 4, the 5, or the 7, or even the VAMK9. But there is one fitted to this one in this particular example. They are optional and can be either installed or removed according to the specifications of the tariff involved. And there we go. I've removed the front case, and as you can see, it's there, it's just loosely swinging away there underneath the time switch. Let's zoom in now and have a look at the star wheel in a bit more detail. What I should do now is remove the time switch from the base. The time switch has now been removed from the base. I've placed it down on the floor and we shall study that in a moment. And there we are. I've reinstated the time switch to the base, and there it is on the wall once again.